You came to the crib, Phil's crib, where he shares his opinions on random topics. And now, here's your host, Phil.
On today's Phil's Crib, we're going to talk about why you should never, ever in your life marry a hyena. Now, this was inspired by a message one of the brothers sent to me about a hyena that he married and he's currently going through a divorce with. So let's go ahead and just read it, and then we'll talk about this because we need to learn from other people. The brother stated, "So I am an army officer and I'm going through a divorce with a hood rat. I met her on Facebook when I was in Afghanistan in 2012. She sent me care packages and daily messages that strung my heartstrings since it can get very lonely out there. So I promised to thank her in person when I returned, which I did. She lived in the ghetto, but didn't seem to have ghetto ways. She cooked, cleaned, spoke the Queen's English, etc. We began a relationship from day one, even though she had a 2-year-old son and 2 older children that her adoptive parents had in custody. Despite this, and having no formal education aspirations or a decent job, I look past that. She proposed to me around 3 months later." Oh, Jesus, brother. No. We're getting to that. "I accepted because we found out we were pregnant. We got married on a Vegas trip a few months after this. During the marriage, she became unbearable and her mental disorders came to light. The straw that broke the camel's back happened in November 10, 2014. One night she got extremely angry, poured water on me, and commenced jumping on me while sitting in my recliner. I simply pushed her off of me and tried to leave. She paused and said, 'Oh, so you want to put your hands on me? So I'm going to call the police and tell them you beat the ish out of me, and then I'm calling your company commander and telling them the same.' She actually did it. Luckily, I did not get arrested, but she tried to pin some old bruises on me in a story to the cops, but they didn't buy it. After I filed divorce, she tried to keep our son away from me as much as she could. She called my job like every day claiming I'm not supporting them and just trying to get me fired. Once I got a lawyer, I was ordered 50-50 time with my child. At a recent Pendite Light hearing, I was awarded temporary primary custody and she was denied alimony altogether. She thought that since I'm a captain, that she would be getting over $900 a month in child support and a ridiculous amount of alimony. I now have to pay her $155 per month only because she has our child for 10 days every month. Bottom line is, I came out really clean in a messy situation, which is not the case for most men. I can truly relate to your video commentary because I, as you say, loathe hood rats. I have learned my lesson. The next relationship I get into will be a woman of real worth and has to have a lot to bring to the table. I am 32 years old and I'm fast tracking in my career. I just cannot believe I fell for the okie doke. Thank God for real men like you take time to educate young brothers on the many risks you take when dealing with hood rats. Brother, say one love." All right, now we're going to break this down. Okay, so I understand his position. He met the girl while he was in war. You know what? Being in that desert, you don't see many females. It's not like Afghanistan. It's like, you know, other countries where they have women roaming around. I mean, they have a strict society. So I get that part of it, okay? So when he got back, he said that this chick had a 2-year-old son. So she just had a kid, 2 older kids, and her adoptive parents had custody of. Now, you need to question that because in most states in America, the courts, family law courts, will give the mother so much leeway. And if they take a child from that mother, something's really up with her. Okay? That's red flag number one. Then he said that she didn't have no formal education, which is a problem. She had no aspirations, which is even worse. And she didn't have a decent job. 3 strikes that men should not be dealing with. You know how a lot of these women, they want you to have a job. They want you to have a place to stay. They want you to have a car. They want you to be a man of substance. I tell a lot of men, the same expectations that this woman have for you, you need to have for them too. Because we live in a time period of equal rights, equal society, everything equal. So you should think that way about these women of today. Because you can't do nothing with no female that ain't got nothing for herself. Because if she attached herself to you, all she gonna do is drag you down. Because she is not your doggone kid. She is an adult that can help you, and you can help each other. But I'm like this, I'm not your daddy. I'm not here to raise you. I'm not here to take care of you, period. So that was a big problem. Then he said, despite all that, she proposed to me after 3 months later. That's another problem. No man, listen to me, I can care less what these feminists say. No man is supposed to allow a woman to ask you to marry her. To me, that's desperate. Obviously, somebody didn't ask her, because let me tell you something. A real woman that men really want to be with have no problem getting a man asking them to marry them. This woman was so thought you was a good guy. She wanted to attach herself to you because she didn't have nothing else going for herself. She just had a 2-year-old kid. Two of her kids was taken away. Okay. And she thinks that, man, I got this guy. Sure, I got no other hope. I better ask him. Maybe he may like this sort of thing. And since he felt like a, you know, gratitude because she was sending care packages, she was keeping him, you know, company in a female way, at least from a distance. You know, he felt like some sort of obligation. Plus, he got her pregnant. Now, that's where you messed up at, too. I tell men, don't be getting these females pregnant. Even if you marry this chick, wait a few years, because you never know. If you marry the wrong person, then you can get out of it. You ain't got to deal with this chick no more. Don't be having a baby right off the jump. But he had the baby. Now, he said this chick had mental problems. If you'd have just waited some time, when it comes to these females and even these hyenas, I tell men, give things the minimum 6 months to a year. People will always show their true colors, because you can't hide your issues within time. Time reveals everybody, male, female. It reveals intentions. It reveals if you're just trying to use somebody. It reveals if something wrong with you. You know, as men, we meet some females and they be like, why is she single? Look how she look. And then you start to know this chick, say, oh, now I see why she's single. This chick is crazy as hell. So I need to get away from her too. Because, you know, men, you know what I'm talking about. They got plenty of women out there like that. They look so good, but then you find out how crazy they are. They just completely turn you off. Or some issues with this chick. You get what I'm saying? She's extremely clingy. Or she can't keep her friends. You know, she's telling all your business. She can't keep stuff within the house. Or she drink too much. Or whatever she got going on. And that's why she is single, even though she may look a certain way. So, you know what I said about hyenas. Hyenas and violence go hand in hand. So, of course, this chick is going to start doing things. Of course, you know, hyenas got mental problems. That's for sure. A lot of hyenas have been through a lot of trauma. So, the only thing they know how to express themselves is through violence. And, you know, like he said, luckily, you did not get killed by the cops. Because, see, you know, as black men, that's a black guy. As black men, how many times black men have been killed at the hands of a lying woman doing this to us? Seriously, there are brothers that have done bids in jail from a lie from a woman because she's crazy. This is why, you know, we have to protect ourselves just as men, okay? Because we know a lot of these cops are killers out here. It don't take much for them to shoot one of us down, and then they'll say, I thought he had a gun. He did this, he did that, I feared for my life, all this other stuff, and nothing happens to the cop. But even if something do happen to the cop, you gone. You not here no more. So that's why we have to be extra careful, especially with these cops, that we deal with women who are women. Get you a decent woman, because a decent woman has a job. A decent woman has a place to stay. A decent woman is going to take care of her kids. She's not going to allow her kids to be taken away from her because she is not right. She's probably a piece of crap mother. That's why they took the kids away. Okay. A real woman's gonna take care of her situation. Like when I met my wife, okay, my wife had a job. My wife had a place to stay. And I made sure when I looked at her place to stay, I looked around, because I say, you know, you want to make sure this woman has, you know, her house clean, not only herself, but her house. Because sometimes these women be out here looking like $1 million, but yet you go in their house and the house is dirty, clothes all over the place. I mean, having smells in it, all kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying? So my wife was always clean. So I said that, you know, impressed me too. Because, man, like, so you get to a certain age, you start looking at a little bit more things than just the way some woman look. You know, you look at, you know, the woman's aspirations. You start talking to her, what you want out of life? You know, where you want to go? What you want to do? You start doing these things, men, with these women. You have to do that, because it's your own fault if you don't weed that junk out at the beginning before you get serious to the point of getting these chicks pregnant or having a kid. Hyenas don't have anything going for themselves. The best thing they got going for themselves is their body and their looks. And some hyenas are good at masking it too, because not every chick is a hyena walking around with her booty out and her titties out and all this other stuff. Some of these hyenas keep themselves clothed very well, but you get to know this chick, she's a hyena, just straight up. She's a hyena hood rat. So men in the future, don't be like this brother to the point that you marrying a hyena and you having a kid with him. The worst thing ever for a man to deal with is impregnating a hyena. Because they're going to use your child as something to give you hell. And then you know how these courts are. So we don't want to be put in that kind of situation, you know, as men. So don't marry the hyenas. Take your time to get to know these chicks. And if this chick has nothing going for herself, leave her alone. Because I'm sorry, she ain't got no car. I ain't fooling with you. You ain't got no job, I'm not fooling with you. You ain't got nothing, no aspirations, no dreams, no nothing. I'm sorry. I'm trying to go somewhere. And you just not doing nothing? No. I can't be doing that sort of thing. And because it gets to a certain point, men, that looks even get, you know, like, okay, yeah, I understand you look good. But what substance you got to bring to the table? Because you ain't bringing no substance, I can't fool with you like that. Sorry, because I'm trying to go somewhere. Now, you know, I tell somebody this, you know, you get to a certain point that, well, you want a chick that's a 10, but got nothing going good for herself, or you want a chick that's maybe a 7 or an 8, but she got a job, she got everything going good for herself, she got aspirations, dreams, she's a good person, she give you the shirt off her back, she humble, she, you know, down to earth, shoot, she a cook, she a clean, all that. Give me the 7 or 8 any day. You can keep that 10. Why? Because I can do something with that 7 or 8. And you know what? Plastic surgery these days, if the chick wants to, she can look that way. So it is up to her. You know what I'm saying? But it's about, really, at the end of the day, I know a lot of women say this, but I'm telling you from the truth. The inside is the thing that counts. The inside is a little bit more important than the outside. The outside could change any given day. Even that chick that's a 10, cause her looks can go down. I've seen that happen to chicks too. I'm like, what happened to her? Man, 5 years ago, she was bad. Now she's like, oh, hell no. Like that. You know what I'm saying? So be careful when you're picking these women. You know, leave the hyenas alone. Get some real women. There's plenty of real women out here. You know, whatever, you know, woman you're looking for, just make sure she has the things that you need as a man to get to where y'all want to be, like, in life. Because the worst thing you want to do is marry a hyena, have a baby with a hyena. Now you got to get a divorce if possible. You know, he came out good, but some dudes don't come out good. Had to get his chick high dollar child support alimony, and then this chick is using child support to take care of her sorry thug dudes that she fooling with is living in the house around your child, and you pissed off. You know, you want your kids out of that situation, all the other stuff. But anyway, leave me your thoughts.
Make sure to subscribe to this channel, where we also feature So Disrespectful YouTube comments and Advice Show Radio. Want news that isn't politically correct or influenced by corporate agenda? Subscribe to the Advice Show TV, where we present media with a common sense approach. Looking for something funny to get you through the day? Subscribe to Ratchet Video Weekly. Thank you for listening, and see you next time.